Will you show me how to make the chicken fried steak?
Absolutely. Well, this is our tenderizer machine here.
It looks like a James Bond interrogation device of some kind. Look at what a lean cut of beef that is. And that just shows what great quality goes into it. All right, so you drop it in once. You drop it in the opposite way. Now, does this make it easier to cook through?
Yes, and it'll be also tender.
This isn't processed. This isn't a fried beef cookie that we got from some plant that then we reconstituted. This is the real deal.
But tenderizing is just the first step of this family tradition. Next, Tim seasons the 7-ounce cutlet with plain salt and pepper. Then he soaks it in a simple wash of 15 eggs to 1 gallon of buttermilk. And then he single breads it in plain flour. And while most places then deep fry their beef, the Stockyard Cafe grills their chicken fried steaks on clarified butter.
You put butter over the top. You're a naughty little monkey. And you can see it has this really nice, palpable, firm crust. It's just gonna seal in all those juices that we saw coming off. Unbelievable. It's all flavor, it's all tradition, and I love the fact that your dad's there and then you're here. It's like two generations worth of family are in there cooking this. That is the type of meal you want. You're gonna come to the beef capital, you want a beef expert behind the wheel, and that's what you're gonna get. You're gonna get a meal that is a true taste of the High Plains, Texas.
So now I have the Youngblood chicken fried steak recipe in my belly, but that was just a warm-up for the